Hey guys, this is Tracy. I wanted to come to you all today and share with you something that I feel that would probably be beneficial to you. So since I'm already getting ready to do that, I didn't see the reason why I wouldn't share with you. But here I have this protective style. This is the crochet braids that I've had in now for a whole four months. Okay, and I want to keep it in at least for another week or so. So what I want to do is show you guys how I'm going to cleanse my scalp as well as oil my scalp. My scalp has like this little dusty, like whitish look film to it. So it looked kind of like it needs some kind of, you know, cleansing a little bit. So I want to share with you guys what all I do to cleanse my scalp when I do have a protective style that I can't put in water. Okay, so first I do is I get some witch hazel, all right, and I will grab up a couple, well, just really one at a time. And that's just a plain old cotton ball, okay. And what I do is take the witch hazel and dip it in there. Just let the witch hazel get onto the cotton ball, kind of like saturate it. All right, once you feel the cotton, your fingers getting wet through the cotton ball, it is wet enough, okay? You can get a little bit more wet, okay? And what I do after that, guys, is I find a place in my scalp, and I just take that cotton ball and just rub this way, all the way through the scalp. I'm going to turn around so you can be able to see what I'm doing. Alright, and what I do is go throughout my whole head without disturbing the hair. It's lightly lifting it up, just like this, where I'm exposing my scalp, and I just rub with that cotton ball, okay, until I get it as, just like that. Now, with this witch hazel, you do not have to rinse it out, so that's what makes it real, real good for a protective style that you can't merge into water. Okay, even though my scalp is not really showing that it needs cleansing, it's that time because I haven't shampooed my hair at all since putting in this protective style. So once I'm done with that cotton ball, I just reach for another one, do this, and just repeat the same procedure until I'm finished. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that on camera so you guys can see what I'm doing. All right, I'm just saturating the cotton ball right now. I think I got it a little too wet because I don't want it to where it's running down in my face. All right, so what I'm doing is I'm going to go through each part and just like work with this cotton ball, just like kind of push it in between the hair. You don't want to really disturb the hair, which means making tangles or pulling it to where it just tangles all up. You just want to go through it and just do this procedure just like this, just as lightly as you possibly can without disturbing the hair, because you want to try to avoid as many wrinkles or frizzies as you possibly can. Okay, I was supposed to cut this hair into some style, but I changed my mind because I did what I call a picture documentary. I'm going to turn around so you can see what I am doing. And I just like lift this up. I don't really try to untangle anything. Yeah, it's tangled up. Some of this hair is tangled up, but oh well, okay? I don't even try to untangle it or anything. I just do what I can with, you know, what I already have here. And I just lightly lift it on up and just run the cotton ball through the scalp that way, okay? And I still got witch hazel on here to where I can just finish the whole entire thing, okay? Then I just go around the hairline doing the same thing. And if I want to, I want to pour a little bit more on this one because I'm going to get like the nape area of my neck. And I didn't want to do too much with that. I just get up on the nails like that. Alright. So yeah, so basically that's it. And if I feel that I left anything out, then I'll just take this cotton ball and just go back in there where I think I left something out and just rewipe. I still don't disturb the hair to where it's not really tangled up. Now you might have a few out of place because you was moving it about, but you can always, you know, put it back to where it was. So that's really it, and now my scalp is cleansed, okay, and it does, I have to say, it does feel really, it feels refreshed, Okay, I want to make sure I don't have nothing dripping all down my neck or anything. But yeah, you don't want to have the cotton ball to where this is just dripping all over the place either. So really that's it, because I don't have to worry about rinsing it out, and this and my scalp is clean, okay? And we could take a look at it. I don't know how much of it you are able to see cleansed or whatever. I can turn around. But this is pretty much how it looks, you know, after doing that, okay? So I was checking my hair yesterday, and I was trying to see if I'm having some, you know, as the hair gets older, it drops, you know, the curls drop. I haven't decided to cut my hair into a style or anything yet, but I don't know. I might. But right now, I really haven't. I got a little bit of this running down my neck. Okay, but I really haven't decided on doing that yet. And that was because I had decided to do a documentary type picture blog. And it was where within each week of me having this hairstyle in, I wanted to do, well, I wanted to see if the hair would drop to where it was noticeable or where you can see it. So I did a blog, and I will put the link to that blog in the description box. That way you can check it out, or what I did. And it's basically where within the full 4 weeks, I took a picture of myself, you know, with the hair out just like this. That's the reason why I decided not to cut it, because I wanted to really see just how long this would last. If you wonder why I'm bending back and forth, I'm checking myself out in the mirror. But yeah, so that was that. So I will put the description, I will put the link to that blog in the description box where you can check it out also. Now the next thing to move on to would be to oil the scalp. The first thing you want to do is get yourself an applicator bottle just like this, okay? Any type of bottle with that long nozzle to it. And inside of it, you want to put whatever oil that you choose to oil your scalp with. I put in mind today is olive oil and some tea tree oil. I chose the tea tree oil is because I was feeling some itchiness going on, and I'm assuming that has to be because my scalp needs to be cleansed. So that was the reason for the witch hazel. So I wanted to go ahead and do this video so that way you can be able to know what it is that I had planned on doing. So I just put some tea tree oil and olive oil inside of here, and then you just want to mix it up. Shaking it just like this, okay? And I did the separating of the hair, putting in the witch hazel to clean the scalp, you want to do the oil the same way. So you just don't want to really disturb the hair. You just want to lift it about. And okay, I'm looking in the mirror, guys, so if you see me not looking at the camera, that's the reason why. And you just want to squeeze the oil a little bit, and you just take it and just rub it in. As you squeeze it out of the applicator bottle, then go ahead and rub it on into your scalp. That way it won't be running all down your neck and all that kind of stuff. You don't need that happening, because sometimes you don't even feel that oil running, and it can be running and down your head and scalp and all everywhere. You don't even feel it. So as you pour it onto your scalp, you feel that part, go ahead and just rub it on in. That way it don't give it a chance to travel. Alright? So that is basically what I do. And let me turn around so I can show you. And I'm just going in between each part that I have with these braids that I braided, and just pouring oil and just rubbing it in this way. Alright? And I really take like big leaps and bounds, because I squeeze the applicator bottle, and as I'm squeezing it, the oil coming out, and I'm just like going through it this way real quickly, because I don't want to, it don't need to be such a big fuss. It really don't. Okay, so that's all I do. Okay, I'll try to be so where you can see what I'm doing. Just do this right across the parts where your braids are, and just squirt and rub. That's the best way I can put it. And that way it gets on into those parts real nice and easy. And you don't have to be doing a lot of manipulation and moving around and all that. All right, so once you have gotten the oil into each part, then you want to massage your scalp to make your head just feel so good. Then you just take your fingers and go through just like this, just lifting the hair. Don't disturb the hair. Still don't disturb it by pulling or yanking on the hair. And just massage in the oil this way. Oh, that feels so good. And you just mainly operating your hands this way. You're working your hands this way. And this way, you're just going, you know, back and forth like this with your hands over your head. You turn around so you can see what I'm doing in the back. Take my hands and I just go into the hair like this. I still don't really disturb the curls of this hair. All right. You want to use the ball parts of your fingers. If you want to use your fingernails, I don't recommend that because you might scratch your scalp. And you really don't want to do that either. And depending on the type of oil that you're using, it might not be good for you to be then open a sore, okay? So that's what I do, and that's really it. And I just do it until my little heart's content and that I am satisfied with what I've done. And, yeah, so this is basically it. And then afterwards, I straighten the hair back out. I'm going to take a look in this mirror to make sure that it looks great. And then I'll just shake, 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 front and back, side to side, and that's really it, okay? And then I'll just really leave it like this because I believe that when you don't really do too much pulling and tugging, you know, like to smash it down, it pretty much keeps its fullness. So this is how it looks in the back. This is the side, and this is the other side. So yeah, so if you find this video helpful, please rate the video, comment, thumbs up at the video. If there's any questions that you may have about anything that I did in this video today, please leave a comment and I will get back with you on that. But I thank you so very, very much for watching, and I hope that this video was helpful because it is quite a few that I know likes this hairstyle, but they're so... You know, they don't really know exactly what to do because they want to maintain the hairstyle. And that is really my purpose of doing this. So I did do, for those that don't know, I did a video to show how I installed this hair into my head and how I did it. And I also did a video to show what I do to wrap it up at night and to, you know, it's just a maintenance video. And I also have done a vlog to show exactly what the hair can look like within a month if you don't tug and pull on it. Like I always say, my main thing to this hair is the less manipulation, the better off it is. And this is exactly what I held to. This hair has held up beautifully, and I'm just so really, I never really had a problem with this hair, and I just recommend anyone that wants to get this hairstyle, get it, do a video response to either one of my crochet braid videos, and I will accept it. I'll be glad to see it, okay? So I want to thank you all so much for watching, and I wish you all a blessed, wonderful day. Remember to put God first in your, and keep him in your heart, your soul, and your mind. Read the word every day. Get that energy. Feed that spirit, okay? So with all else, I think there's nothing else I have to say. But thanks so much for watching. I hope that this video was helpful. So you all have a blessed, wonderful day. Oh, remember, Happy New Year's! I wish everyone a very, very Happy New Year. I'm sorry I was not able to get on and just make a special video about New Year's, but I'm saying it now. Happy New Year's. Have a prosperous New Year. Whatever your goals are for 2013, achieve them. Don't stop it. You started it. Keep going until you finish. That's my thing. All right. So with that being said, have a good day. Bye.